Hello, internets. So a lot of you who watch Prince of Persia speedrunnings are like, this is cool. I remember playing that game as a kid. I want to play it too. Well, you can. There's no reason why you can't. And it's actually pretty easy, relatively. So you can, boom. You can go to a website like this one, which I have like four different websites down. Click start. It's going to make an annoying noise. Right there. Okay. Full screen it. Boom. Full screen Prince of Persia here. All on a website. Play it right away. Right off the bat. Play it. It's going to have black bars on the side, but that's cool. And this is Prince of Persia. This is the same Prince of Persia you played as a kid. The aspect ratio is a little bit different, but let's see. Oh, we can even do cool things on it. And so this is a completely Control R. We can restart the level. We can turn off the sound. This is Prince of Persia, the same one that you played as a kid. You can even quit out of it and type Prince Mega Hit 2. And you can... Oh, this has... All right, so this one has copyright protection. So you can definitely... Let's see, drink this potion. Yeah. Oh, that's not it. Let's drink this potion. Maybe this is it. Okay. So anyway, point being is that, so wait a second. If this is the first version of the game, PRINCEGA, you can play in EGA mode on a website. And look, the prince is, he's not a blonde haired guy anymore. He's like, you know, he's got red hair for some reason, but ooh, let's see here. Prince CGA. Look, you can play in CGA. Wait, can you play in appearance? Okay. So you can't play in Hercules, but you can play Mega Hit. And jump to level 3, and control. Like, you can do a whole bunch of cool stuff with this. Shift L. See, like... This is cool. Anyway, Paul, this is all on a website. You can play it on a website. Now, you might not want to play it on a website. Because if you want to speedrun, now mind you, I started speedrunning on a website, but you probably want to play just a nicer version. There's a version you can download. And it's also in the description. It is this one. SDLPoP. SDLPoP allows you to play on Windows, on Linux, on Mac. You can download this version. When you do, at least for Windows, let me see here. Boop. You'll extract it, and when you open the folder, you'll probably have to left-click it, properties, and click something right here that says, yeah, it's all right for it to play on my computer. And then you can play Prince of Persia on your computer. You can even full screen it like this. And this is everything that was true of the other one, except for this one. I don't think you can play in CGA mode. Or maybe you can. I don't know. But you can play this one. It's, for some strange reason, it's choppy. I don't know why. Uh-oh. But this is Prince of Persia. It plays just like the other one. And, ooh, You can even perform tricks on it. You can also disable tricks. And, oh, see, there's a setting menu. You can go gameplay. You can turn off a bunch of... turn on a bunch of things that fix things. Skeleton Chomper Blood. You can also play mods using this. It's really cool. Version of Prince of Persia, more kind of modern. There's a few little things, but otherwise it plays just like Prince of Persia that you know of already. All right, so let's say that you actually want to play Prince of Persia like you see us play it. You want to play it the right way, what I would call it the right way. Not that this is bad. Not that playing on the website is necessarily bad, but you want to like have no delay. You want to play it the right way. So what I'm going to suggest you do is you go to whatever website you're at. You go to your web browser, you type in speedrun.com/POP for Prince of Persia 1. And you go here. This, of course, has the rankings for the 80%, and you can change all the different rankings and stuff, but it also has this little thing here that says guides. Click on guides, and click here where it says how to play the game, which is what this video is all about. So, how to play the game. It says download DOSBox. It gives you a link to DOSBox. You want to download the, well, if you're playing on Windows, the Windows one here. Download DOSBox. It says you want to open the DOSBox folder. And in the DOSBox folder, there is this thing called options.bat. Open that up. Now, there's two things that you really need to do, just because it'll make life easier. One is that you need to mount wherever you're going to put your game. Mount it. So I've mounted C drive, and I've mounted C drive / old games. So I've mounted C drive in DOSBox to C drive / old games, C colon, and then I have changed the directory to Prince. I've done that. This makes it easy for me. You also want to go all the way up here to cycles, and you wanted to set it to 20,000 or max. After you have done that, you now want to make sure that you have Prince of Persia downloaded. So, Prince of Persia can be gotten from this site, gotten, can be achieved, acquired from this site, where we have all of the versions of Prince of Persia. The site also somewhere has all the mods and stuff, but these are all the versions of Prince of Persia. This is the one you need if you're going to speed run, or if you want the latest version. This has the colored levels, where level 3 is green and such, and level 8 is kind of a brownish, a grayish color, a dark grayish color. This is the folder that you want to download. This is the zip file. Anyway, point being is that after you've downloaded that, you put it into your POP folder, and then you can play the game. However, you're going to run into problems. And this part right here doesn't exactly explain it fully. So let me go back up to here on guides again. Go to here, sound initialization error. So when you start running the game, you're going to get this error. Now, how you fix that error is by going into your directory, setup, setup. When you pick Sound Blaster again, you want to press M to modify, and you want to click all of the defaults. The reason why you want to do that is because if you don't, and you click, if you don't, this is set to this, but this is actually set to auto detect. And that's where the initialization error happens. IRQ set to 7. Save. Yes. Prince of Persia. Max cycles. Starts. And this version, of course, is the best in every way. Except for you can't do the CGA and EGA and all that sort of stuff. Download an earlier version if you want to do that sort of stuff. But you can, of course, do tricks. You can hit the game and do prints. It's not Mega Hit this time, it's Improved. And go to level 5. It's playing through all the levels. 1 through 4. That's the reason why it's taking so long. Oh, so you can go, and because you've done Improved, you also have all the things. See, I just killed the guard by pressing K. This is where you have all the glitches. Die, guard. Okay, cool. So this is how you can play Prince of Persia on DOSBox. And of course, you can full screen this as well. So, now that I've shown you 3 ways in which you can play Prince of Persia, I would like to just go over that here on speedrun.com/pop1/guides, we also have setting up live split. This will teach you all about setting up your live split. And I think this also sets up your auto detector. It tells you about how to set up your auto detector. So your auto splitter, so that you just have to load up your, what is it called again? Anyway, once you start the game, your splits will start happening on their own. That's what this guide is for. This is a good thing that'll show you all of these things that you see here are the glitches that are considered glitches that you cannot use in a no major glitch run. This is a non-inclusive list because there might be some things that are considered glitches that are not these, but basically, as long as you're not doing any of these things, you're good. You're kosher to do your no major glitches run. And there we go. Prince of Persia can be played in many different ways. This even shows you how to play it in the Apple II, the original Prince of Persia. We're so excited that you want to play Prince of Persia. And hopefully you will. All you have to do, look, I want to show you guys here. Boom. Leaderboard. Full leaderboard. Leaderboard. Not individual levels. Full leaderboard. I just want to show you guys. We only have 26 runners. That means that if you run, even if you do absolutely the worst you could, but you still beat the game, and you submit the run of you playing, you're now in 27th place. You're the 27th greatest Prince of Persia player in the world. And all you have to do is record yourself playing it and submit it. It's easy to be a speedrunner, guys. I'm giving you all the things. Additionally, if you want to make sure that you are doing a good job speedrunning, mind you, this is only a video to show you how to play the game, but if you want to speedrun, I suggest getting a good monitor. That is one with a low response time, and then getting a nice keyboard. And that's all you need. Like, we had somebody who beat Prince of Persia, who got a speedrun world record on a laptop on an airplane. So, just to tell you, like, you don't need a bunch. Just start playing the game and then start trying to get better. Don't worry, in about a week, you'll have beaten the game. If you play it 2 hours a day, in a week, you'll have the game beaten. It's not... Okay, anyway, Stop the game. Stop recording.